想 OK 嘅話，我哋可以正式開始啦。OK 係咪？好，咁大家可以坐翻
係。咁早前咧亦都詢問個提名顧問委員會咧，有關於功能組別地產及建造界功能組別嘅參選資格。咁最後時間咧亦都確認咗，即係我有呢個資格係參選咁啦。咁亦都講下呢個界別嘅一個組成咁樣。咁由呢個香港建設商會啦、香港地產建設商會啦，同埋呢個香港建造商商會會員啦，同埋呢個機電工程商會會員嘅。咁亦都好困難地咧，亦都想嘗試下呢個界別，因為全部都係大部分係公司票，即使係個人票咧，都係由一啲公司去授權嘅。咁亦都嘗試喺較為有機會嘅界別，即係可能係機電工程商協會咧，我亦都嘗試過 send 好多嘅 email 啦，幾百封嘅 email 俾一啲唔同嘅中小企，係嘗試係爭取呢啲界別嘅一啲嘅提名票。咁亦都即使係咁困難咧，我相信即係有意參選呢一樣嘢咧，已經係咁多年嚟，即係22年嚟咧都未有人係挑戰過呢個界別，亦都係石禮謙係20年嚟咧係把持住呢個地產及建造界嘅一個功能界別啦。咁亦都好希望係可以突破到呢一個嘅框架。咁亦都我亦都想反映翻，其實呢個界別嘅存在咧，其實係好荒謬。我覺得即係大地產商我哋。聽聞過很多有名的新鴻基、新世界，甚至乎長實，其實是不需要一個代議士去代表他們。我覺得今時今日這些這樣的功能界別是必須要廢除，因為我覺得立法會議員作為一個代議士是應該為民發聲。如果這個界別是能夠代表到地產代理界也好，建造業的工人也好，我覺得這些存在都或可以接受，但係今時今日功能界別真係非常之荒謬。我哋即使佢確認咗個資格，我都冇辦法可以有機會爭取到提名。但我想今日講一講，就係簡單講一講嗰、那個自己嗰個理念咯。希望係爭取到或者帶透過參選係帶出咗咧青年住屋嘅問題。即可能有其他自由黨亦都有意參選嘅人都提出咗，即係辣椒要廢除等等。希望即係買間花税一定要保留，要限制大陸人買樓。但係我覺得 double stamp duty 香港人可以即係解除翻啲辣椒，或者更加多啲我哋年青人嘅一啲印花税嘅豁免，即係首次置業嘅港人嘅樓可以起多啲，包括引用收回土地條例，收回高爾夫球場，我哋增辟好多嘅土地，亦都係受惠翻我哋嘅中小企可以有生意做，亦都香港人要重建一個。我哋嘅希望，即係見到陳建波講到話，我哋收成期，我哋年輕人係見唔到有收成期，所以希望如果有良心嘅中小企，以至去到機電工程商，有啲可能冷氣機工程嘅公司，可以提名我嘅，希望可以聯絡。我係李永財灣仔區議員，多謝大家。
跟住有請金融服務界林浩波。
Hello， 各位傳媒朋友，大家好，歡迎大家嚟臨，我係林浩波，南區區議員。金融服務界別咧，過去30年咧，一直被建制派所壟斷。我作為呢個界別民主派嘅唯一參選人，我希望藉住今次嘅參選，去創造競爭，打破壟斷。我需要更多嘅提名票，令我可以成功入閘，正式成為候選人。喺我嘅政綱方面，喺金融市場而言啦，資訊嘅自由流通係非常之重要嘅。亦都可以令到我，亦都可以令到市場嘅運作更加有效率。而香港穩健的法治制度咧，係作為香港國際金融中心的其中一個重要嘅基石。作為一個自由的經濟體，市場的運作係唔應該受到政治的任何干預。在業界方面啦，好多券商同我講，政府同埋監管機構根本冇重視或者了解過佢哋所面對日常經營的困難同埋問題，而現任的議員亦都冇建立有效的溝通渠道去反映業界的問題。我希望進入議會去代表業界發聲，改善他們的營商環境。守金融專業，破界別細集，我需要更多的提名票，請支持我林浩波，我是民主派唯一的參選人在金融服務界裡面。謝謝。
Thank you. Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Lee Faulkner. I'm a British actuary. I've lived in Hong Kong for 9 years, and I'm standing for the insurance functional constituency. I'm sorry I don't speak Cantonese, and I apologise. If you want to see some notes, these notes that I'm referring to here, then you can speak to some of my team afterwards if you would like that help. As I said, I'm standing for the insurance functional constituency seat. This seat is decided by 134 insurance companies. But in Hong Kong today, in the insurance industry, there are about 130,000 direct stakeholders. That's agents, brokers, and employees. But only 134 bodies can vote on behalf of these 130,000 people. So that is not democracy. That is 21st century feudalism. About two-thirds of these 134 companies can actually be classed as foreign if you look at their history, their heritage, and where their holding companies are based. And some of them are not even domiciled here in Hong Kong, but they have the vote. So isn't it foreign collusion to give these companies the vote rather than giving it to 130,000 Hong Kongers? There's only ever been one vote in this seat, in the five that have been held since the handover. The other four were shoo-ins. The insurance seat has not had a vote since 2008. I think we desperately need to have a debate and an election in this seat, and not yet another shoo-in. For that to happen, I need to get nominated. And to get nominated, I have to appeal to insurers' best interests. Some have responded positively to our campaign, and some have remained silent. Some of them have said, we don't want to get involved. Okay, we don't want to nominate anybody, means they want to stand aside and not get involved. Some have responded positively. One lady who has nominated us, she said that she was, the minute she saw my letter, she wanted to phone me immediately and nominate me. She wants to see change in this seat. Others are concerned about the effect on their business of nominating me. I understand that. I get it. Of course I do. It's very difficult for some companies to do that. But I think the majority of insurance companies want to stay out of this. They don't want to get involved in politics unless they have to. And the best way to help them stay out of it is for them to help me get this voting system removed once and for all. Now, there are some things that companies can do to lessen the impact on their image. Some of them have got multiple votes because they've got multiple licenses, so they can appear to be unbiased in that sense. Others do not have business interests in China, so it doesn't actually matter. They don't have any political pressure to respond to. But remember, it's only the nominations themselves that are public. Once we get 10 nominations, then it moves on from there to the election stage, and the election stage itself is a secret ballot. There are very many important issues that need to be addressed in the insurance sector, and my platform has three main parts to it. The first is to expand insurance in a sustainable way. That means making insurance accessible to everybody, not just high net worth individuals. And it also means replacing the utterly useless MPF scheme. Secondly, we have to make Hong Kong itself sustainable. That means dealing with the aging crisis rather than just ignoring it and hoping it will go away. And thirdly, we have to address ethics. It's about time that Hong Kong politicians had the same ethical standards that we all do when we obey our professional codes and those of our employers. So, each of the 134 registered electors has the privilege of voting on our behalf and on behalf of all of its stakeholders. With privilege comes responsibility. So I urge insurers to accept that responsibility and to do the right thing. We need a debate and we need an election. We do not need yet another shoo-in. But that can only happen if insurers accept their responsibility and allow a vigorous debate and election to happen. For that to happen, I need to get nominations. Thank you.
積極考慮參選呢個旅遊界別嘅習仲基。咁旅遊界別係全部公司票嚟嘅，暫時嚟講係1400多間公司去投優票投呢個界別。佢係分三大組嘅，第一個組別咧就係旅行社持牌旅行社，第二個組別咧就係酒店，酒店東主，第三個界別咧就係航空公司。咁喺我今次積極考慮參選嘅過程裏面咧，咁我就聯絡啲業界朋友，希望爭取一啲提名啦。就發覺是非常困難的。個困難在於咧，就係因為而家香港很多嘅旅遊行業都跟中國有關係。譬如話，你睇下呢啲大嘅旅行社，很多大嘅旅行社已經被中資收購咗啦。中小企旅行社 中小企業成日話，我如果問題令俾你，因為個提名是公開的嘛，咁我好難會喺啲大嘅我哋叫住 wholesaler 嗰裏面攞機票。咁呢個係佢哋有恐懼。好啦，到我哋啲入境遊嘅公司啦，入境遊基本上而家去香港嚟講，八成嘅公司都係做大陸嘅團客嘅。咁我哋更加唔可以就係提名我啦。可能到只有好少數、好少數一啲服務一啲外國人嘅公司，但係佢哋都坦白講句，呢幾個月呢個行業生計都好有問題，心情都好差劣，仲有冇精神，仲有冇興趣去做呢啲嘢咧？其實佢哋都係好 struggling， 即係佢係好困難地做一件事嗰時，佢哋好驚提名我。咁我都希望透過呢個機會同嗰位業界朋友講，以往經濟好、生意好，你唔提名俾民主派好正常，但今次。就算你支持政府，不支持政府，你都是生意歸零的時候，大家不如放手一搏吧。香港如果你不放手一搏的話，只是坐在那裡等政府給錢你，都應該沒什麼機會。因為就算現在我們的建制派的議員去積極跟這個政府拿錢，都是拿幾年出來，選個非建制的朋友進去這個議會，可能分分鐘有其他的突破都不出奇。那都希望大家能夠支持，給一些努力，即係俾啲呢個提名票我，周永基，多謝大家。
大家好，我係黃偉信，我係工程界民主派唯一嘅代表。咁今日咧係即係我嚟到係絕對係撐一班同路人嘅。其實係藉住今次嘅選舉咧，咁過去幾個月我哋民主派嘅協調咧，咁都好高興可以認識到一班好有熱誠，但係好真心為香港人。去謀福利，去爭取我哋香港人嘅應該有嘅權益嘅一班同路人，係好開心的。咁我自己而言啦，咁今日我想講一個重點就係、是、個主題就係打破壟斷。其實我哋呢班功能組別嘅其中六個代表啊，咁其實有個共通點嘅，就係、是、我哋呢個議席一直都係被保皇黨。建制派壟斷了很多年，咁我攞我個業界代表為例啊，盧偉國議員，咁我哋現任嘅工程界代表盧議員咧，我翻查記錄，佢八年嚟係啦，作為一個立法會議員，應該最主要履行嘅職務就係監察政府或者為政府提出建議，佢嘅質詢嘅數量八年嚟，大家聽清楚係29，即係佢平均每年。書面包括口頭質詢3.幾，我攞翻，我唔好攞區嚟，我就係攞翻專業人士嚟作比較，譬如醫學界啊、建測規員等等咧，佢哋一般啊，至少啊都有數十或者過百個呢啲咁嘅質詢，29絕對係非常冷待表面，但係點解會出現到咁嘅情況？就是因為大家縱容這些這樣高票當選被這些保皇黨他們覺得自己躺在這裡都贏的一些人是其實大家容許他令到這樣做是發揮不到立法會一個議員應該要為業界為香港人爭取福利爭取最大的利益是完全做不到這個效能其實大家試想一下我之前都寫過一篇文章幻想下35家呢啲咁樣嘅懶惰嘅，好似盧偉國咁嘅議員喺個議會度，就係、是、促成今日香港2020年一個咁嘅困局嘅一個主要原因。咁我希望大家唔係借工程業界，其他嘅功能組別，如果想見到香港係有一個好嘅將來，唔想而家再係一個咁沉淪嘅香港，希望大家俾提名。投票表態，你哋自己係打破呢個咁壟斷、咁荒謬嘅一個議會唔健康嘅情況嘅出現。多謝大家。
各位傳媒朋友，大家好，我係張秀賢，係已經參選咗呢個批發權手界。咁當然我嚟呢度咧，因為我交表，當然我繼續去攞個提名啦，因為我都覺得要攞多少少咧。咁我哋呢度撐各位。即係其他嘅界別嘅朋友喺功能組別選舉咧係好需要勇氣嘅。你如果你即係覺得功能組別選舉係好舒服嘅選舉咧，啊對建制派嚟講咧係嘅，佢瞓喺度贏嘅，瞓喺度攤喺度咧唔 使做嘢都會有提名嘅，係冇人同佢競爭，自動當選，做足廿年幾爽。但係對民主派嚟講咧，攞十個提名都好困難，因為民主派唔係嚟自嗰啲既得利益集團，唔係嚟自於大集團大財團，所以最終講緊連入閘都有困難。呢啲功能組別選舉，當然我哋民主派嘅唯一嘅期望就係取消功能組別，全面直選立法會，因為呢個先係我哋確保到立法會起到翻為香港人服務、為香港嘅公共利益去作出最對政府作出最大嘅監察、最有效去監察政府管治嘅一個機構。而而家立法會正正就係因為功能組別嘅存在，所以失去咗呢個功能。去年的逃犯條例修訂，你見到功能組別咧冇民意壓力、冇選民壓力，第一個站起身撲出嚟支持，結果咪搞成香港咁咯。香港經濟差，香港而家導致今日咁嘅局面，功能組別嘅議員係應該要負上最大嘅責任。我哋而家挑戰佢哋，就因為令到佢哋希望促進競爭，令到佢哋最尾都係需要受到媒體、受到選民嘅監察。雖然嗰啲選民都可能係佢哋自己，但係受到香港人嘅監察，一個有競爭嘅選舉先可以令到成個嘅選舉過程公開。即使嗰個選舉係一個非常之不公平嘅選舉，功能組別就係一個不公平嘅存在。有公司票，呢啲公司票仲係受到大財團嘅把持，呢啲正正係我哋而家面對最大嘅困難。所以希望呢啲嘅界別嘅朋友，即係可以俾張提名票出嚟。俾提名票咧，你唔一定要支持佢嘅。正如我咧嗰陣時幫 Plan B 去揾，你啲區議會入閘十張提名票，我個 Plan B 得七票啫。啊，所以你俾提名佢唔一定要支持佢，你俾提名佢係可以為咗促進競爭，可以為咗謀求進步。而大家記住，最尾投票嘅意向係保密嘅，最尾都係個 secret ballot。如果大家覺得支持某一個人，你咪投落去咯。西華問你啲乜，你唔需要答正常嘅答案㗎，你唔需要答一個即係誠實嘅答案㗎。即係你可以同佢講你好誠實，你答嗰個人，但係唔一定最尾係做嗰回事。因為我哋見到就係喺呢啲界別入邊，中聯辦咧個箍票能力咧箍得好實嘅，特別係講緊喺啲百幾票嗰啲界別。老實講，你投嗰票。估得到啦，即係嗰本選民名冊仲薄過一個，即係仲薄過一個中學學生會，知道個選舉幾唔公平。所以促進競爭其實就係打破壟斷嘅第一步。我哋都唔好講贏唔贏嘅問題，因為在座咁多位，我哋呢啲界別從來未有民主派贏過嘅，可能工程界有少少選委贏過，但其他真係未贏過。我自問。其實我落直，即係我諗在座可能好多人落直選都冇問題啦。即係點解要去即係嘥時間落功能組別度？點解要打啲咁艱難嘅組別？就係因為我見到呢啲界別遲早都要有競爭，應該有競爭。我哋舊年區議會都覺得有啲區牢不可破，打唔冧啦。結果咪一樣翻盤翻好緊要。即係不過你見到得翻幾個區係好嘅，即係你見到嗰個世界變咗，經歷嗰一場反送中運動。個政治生態，我哋好多嘅人嘅諗法，包括可能啲商界嘅諗法、專業界別嘅諗法，都已經變咗嘅。促進競爭就係為咗要令到嗰啲候選人最終要去為咗公共嘅利益，為咗佢界別嘅利益負責。而舊年我哋見到建制派好多功能組別嘅議員，為咗逃犯條例修訂，即係促進法寶去護航。你見到就係佢哋。就是為了要保住政府的顏面，要為了要去做好他保皇黨的角色，什麼都做得出。我們去挑戰他，正正就是要令到我們要突顯到功能組別的選功能組別候選人都需要面對香港人，都需要面對市民。我們要奪取議會過半，功能組別就是關鍵的戰場，所以希望大家給提名，勇敢俾提名出嚟，支持民主派嘅候選人可以入到呢界別入邊，去挑戰建制派，令到建制派要受到選舉嘅真正嘅洗禮，要受到媒體嘅監察，要面對香港人去展述佢哋對香港未來嘅願景。唔該。
唔該曬咁多位候選人。咁而家係 Q&A session， 有冇記者係想而家提問，定係可能等陣各自再揾唔同嘅候選人問，定係依家提問，定係各自？
想問下咧，各自而家暫時攞到幾多提名票，同埋即係有冇信心可以喺未來嘅日子可以即係爭取到足夠嘅提名？
可以首先講咗媒體係
邊間媒體有啱播㗎？蘋果日報，聽唔到 ，sorry，
蘋果日報，好，問曬所有候選人，
所有候選人問曬。
我想問下大家，即係未報名嗰四位咧，其實而家各自攞到幾多提名啦，同埋即係有冇信心喺未來嘅日子可以攞到足夠提名咁樣咧？同埋頭先淨係得旅遊界講到攞提名嘅時候有啲咩困難啦？其他界別攞提名嘅時候會唔會都有咩困難喺度咧？
頭先都講過少少喎，即係都係主要係一啲公司票啦，地產及建造界。咁大部分都係一啲政府有關聯嘅一啲公司嘅，因為你一環扣一環嘅，永遠你嘅工程界，你永遠係要需要揾建材或者一條龍，你都係以至細到去燈飾工程，你都全部都要靠政府。所以其實我呢個界別相信個最終入能夠入閘機會係好渺茫嘅，但係幾多張提名票暫時就唔透露住咁樣。
唔該曬。我哋其實咧我哋仍然係繼續去爭取更加多嘅提名票，因為其實我哋嘅目的係想入閘，去增加呢個選舉嘅競爭性。咁我就呼籲大家，如果係未俾提名票嘅話，希望你哋可以俾到提名票俾我，令到可以我可以監察呢個政府同埋為業界發聲。多謝曬。
Okay, I understand the question is how many nominations have we received? Is that right? Yeah. Okay. More than I thought we'd get, but not enough, is the answer. Okay. It's kind of a lose-lose question for me. If I told you I had one nomination, then you'd think, oh, it's a waste of time continuing. If I told you I had 9 nominations, then you would say, oh, well, it's no point because somebody else is going to do it. So I'd rather not give the exact number, but it's more than I thought we'd get, but it's not enough, and we need more. Thank you.
咁啊，講下旅遊界啦。旅遊界而家基本上咧個提名票咧就喺介乎入閘與唔入閘之間，因為而家就係情況就話有一啲所謂即係已經提名咗我朋友咧，都因為有一啲壓力啊，即係佢哋都同我講有啲壓力收到，咁變咗佢哋都要再考慮下提名我嘅情況。所以我而家情況就係話咧希望能夠呢幾日快啲更加多嘅朋友俾多啲提名票我，保證就算我甩咗啲票咧都可以。有其他後備票可以保得住，這個就是希望我今次坐在這裡的原因。
兩位沒有補充的話，有沒有其他媒體有問題？
想你要講集啦，
仲有沒有其他問題？
同埋都想問埋，係咪都認同35+嘅目標？如果真係入閘嘅話，會個方向係點樣？都會即係講到我對不認同，我係難
民。難民就問曬6位嘅係咪？
因為可能基於我的機會都好渺，我是會 OK 的，即是35+是。
可能
啊。
我覺得即是不如講，即係其實一個議案的好同壞咧，我哋係會以專業角度去分析究竟個議案係好定唔好，先至會作出決定。咁同時係會
大聲少少啊，唔好意思。
哦 ，sorry， 唔好意思啊。我話即係如果即係依個議案嘅好同埋唔好咧，個 pros and cons 其實係我哋要以專業嘅角度去分析每一個議案係點樣嘅。咁同埋我哋會取得一個平衡啦，就係公眾嘅利益同埋業界嘅利益，即係咁樣。
Okay, the question was, what do I think about 35+? I think it's a very admirable campaign, and I personally support it. In terms of my geographical vote, I will support the 35+ candidates.My seat, the insurance functional constituent seat is not on the target list for 35+, so I'm not included in that. But as a general aim, I think it's a very worthwhile aim and I support it.
功能組別就同地區直選會少少唔同嘅。功能組別咧，我哋真係要睇翻業界嘅利益同埋業界嘅訴求。咁我今次嘅積極考慮參選咧，就係其中一個想法就係。如果我哋有一啲對於業界有切身利益嘅提案咧， 我哋都會再一次徵詢啲我哋嘅選民嘅意見。咁對於35+嗰個背後概念咧，我係理解嘅。但係實際操作上咧，我哋要睇翻當時嗰個議會嘅組成，究竟係35、36、37、38、39，其實個玩法可以好唔同。所以呢個答案咧，我諗留翻選舉完之後再決定好啲。
係就我而言咧，咁35+係非常之好嘅一個諗法同概念，係可以令到立法會同埋政府作出一個制衡。咁去打破而家就係話壟斷啦，保皇黨點樣瞓喺度舉手一啲好爭議性嘅議題，或者好似上年嘅逃犯修訂條例，200萬上街，佢都可以照瞓喺度舉手盲撐。我哋入到去就係要打破啲咁荒謬嘅一啲規矩，咁可以令到我哋嘅議員真係為民生反映民意，可以俾到立法會可以做到一個正常嘅運作。咁而頭先講到話同埋我想補充喺度借呢個機會咧，我哋嘅對手即係保皇黨或者建制派咧，不斷咁樣話抹黑我哋，話我哋全部都係攬炒派。其實我想喺呢度講清楚，佢哋先係真正嘅攬炒派，反映唔到民意，做唔到一個議會議員應該做嘅職責，佢哋先係攬炒，同埋令到點解香港今時今日搞到咁民不聊生。他們應該要很深切地反省，想想他們過往那麼多年是做什麼，是的，將無論業界的意見反映不到，無論是市民意見亦都反映不到給政府，大家值得去思考的問題就是為什麼會發生這些情況。真正的攬炒是他們這班保皇黨盲撐政府，加上政府完全體恤不到個民意，不知道民情，而導致到今天今時今日香港咁困難、咁困局，呢個係值得政府同埋一班盲撐政府嘅保皇黨去反思，希望佢哋可以深切反思。咁頭先臨尾講到財政預算案，咁我自己而言啦，工程師係啦，我哋係專業理性，係啦，講科學理據，所有嘅議案，無論包括財政預算案，我都要好審慎，係逐份的議案去審議，如果他份議案是好的，是 OK 的，同埋我亦都問業界意見，加上廣大市民的利益為福祉嚟作考慮，如果份議案是值得支持就支持，不值得支持就不值得支持，亦都是議會是一個議員的職能嚟嘅，係去究竟無論是投贊成票啊。是 提出修正案還是反對，所以這一刻沒有理由可以有人說到，譬如我保皇黨，總之進去就舉手了，我是贊成，不合理的，整個不 make sense 的，他進去的職能就是要審視嘛，是啊，他而作出贊成、反對或者是作修正，這個就是我想提出的，大家不要被保皇黨搞亂了，你是反對的，你什麼都反對，這個不是我們，尤其是我覺得在議會裡功能組別是兄弟爬山，跟區是很不同的，剛才有朋友說我們功能組別遊戲，既然我遊戲規則是這樣，我們應該盡最大的能量可以發揮到功能組別我們應該做到的事情。你看看方不方
戴耀廷說45+嘛，所以是不是要看35+，我覺得35+也好45+也好，那個是一個談判必要的一個的做法來的，即是沒有這個條件，我看不到說政府會聽某些聲音或某些訴求，所以這個是基本一步當然你說去到說大家最後怎樣去談，或者我們這個功能組別來說，功能組別在某些位置裡面可能大家會覺得是不是選擇保守一點，例如我們那些簽確認書說的立場特別的模糊，我想是這個我們認為最適合我們的選舉的策略，那這個我想直選的朋友都會明白的，即是我都跟不同的直選的候選人 都有談過，那當然你說是財政預算案方面，我想我們一定是會看回實際的內容，例如說看回財政預算案有我們的政綱，那我當然想我們政綱缺一不可的，如果我們政綱缺一不可的，那我就收貨，那就支持了，如果沒有的 我是覺得不值得支持，那我就跟反對了， 所以最尾都好視乎實際嘅情況。要支持咧，我哋唔係保皇黨啊，唔係佢俾乜嘢嘅財政預算，我哋支持嘅。大家記得2011年嗰陣時啊，唔派錢又支持，派錢財政上又支持，即係我哋俾佢哋咧，我哋起碼仲會講一個原則，佢會講準則，佢哋係照單全收，不論點都會支持。所以呢個係我哋同佢哋去擔任業界嘅代表最唔同嘅地方。
我都想補充啊 Tommy 一句，頭先講嗰樣嘢咧，係而家現實嘅狀況。我想講翻昔日嘅議會啊，建制派係會就住財政預算案，如果佢哋有意見，係會反映，係會作出修正案，而唔係好似今天咁全體通過盲撐，一個修正案都唔提。這個是非常之不健康和可悲的。我們很想走進來，好像剛才 Tommy 說，我們給一些競爭現在的一些很懶惰的建制派議員，他就算我們選不進去都可以踢得動他，他可以做一些正常一個議員應該要做的職責，可以回復昔日的議會正常議會的運作，回復一個正常的香港，是我們這麼多位有心人都是想做的共同目標。
我又想補充一下，就話不如大家想像一下咧，陣時35+嘅議會，即係民主派35+嗰陣時，咁保皇黨會點算咧？係咪話我哋如果提出一啲議案對香港社會有利嗰陣時，佢係咪會支持我哋，抑或會盲反對我哋咧？咁變咗佢哋係反對黨嚟喎。所以我覺得問呢個問題嗰陣時，我會同一時間問翻保皇黨：如果35+真係成立嗰陣時，咁你哋保皇黨會點算好咧？咁你會點投票呢？我都好有興趣知道。
有冇其他媒體有其他問題？
想問曬六位，即係會唔會
邊間媒體啊？
東方。想問曬六位咧，會唔會簽財政算啦？即係如果係升到9%嘅話，同埋即係點樣評估？即係到時即係會唔會即係俾人點嘅時候咧？
這個我暫時未考慮到的，因為如果有幸夠提名的話，我想都可能會考慮簽的，因為想我自己跟劉永康的那個看法差不多，即我認為即要減少，即不是說這個政權雖然你說簽不簽都是會 DQ， 但是如果我什麼都做足的時候你 DQ 我的話，那這個是赤裸裸的一個政權，可以告訴大家它是赤裸裸地干預的選舉。
这个是功能组别选举，我参加的是也是参加一个金融服务界别的选举，而金融服务界别是一个高度集中的专业界别来的，是一个很艰难的选举。在过去的30年是没有一个民主派的参选人是胜出过这个界别的，所以如果確認書是今次選舉的必要條件，我是會考慮去簽的，去令到這個選舉的競爭性增加，從而帶業界聲音進去議會那裡。
I understand the question to be, would I sign the confirmation letter? Is that right? Yes, I would sign the confirmation letter. If I didn't sign the confirmation letter, what would have been the point of everything we've been doing for the last 2 or 3 months and all the effort that all of my team have been put into this campaign?We've raised a lot of expectations and a lot of interest in a seat that was previously thought to be completely dead. I take responsibility for resuscitating it and for being a Lazarus-type seat for something that's now in play. My team have done an awful lot to help me. A lot of people are following us and are interested in doing that, and I'm not going to screw everything up by not signing a confirmation letter. So, absolutely, yes, I will sign it.
多謝記者問題先。咁啊，就旅遊界其實上次有人參有呢個非建制派嘅朋友參選咧，已經係講緊2008年嘅司馬文，都有成12年係冇一個非建制嘅朋友嚟喺度出選嗰時咧。其實今次好多一啲我哋嘅同路人咧，都俾翻啲建議我，就係話叫我去簽佢選，因為佢哋都好想有一個競爭性，真真正正有競爭性。雖然呢幾屆都會有一啲建制派自己互打啦、互鬥啦。但係佢想有一個非建制嘅朋友入去入閘去選舉，所以我都聽過佢哋嘅一啲業界嘅情況咧，都考慮會簽呢個強選嘅。 咁同埋最緊要咧，就係我都上一年選，即係我上一年選呢個斯洛文道區議員嗰時咧，我有簽確認書，所以我想 consistent 我嘅做法咁樣。
好，回應翻個問題，我係簽咗嘅。咁我想講多少少就係、即係簽定唔簽係冇問題嘅。即係我覺得兄弟爬山，可能每一個人都有一啲係 detail 嘅位去support 佢簽或者唔簽。咁但係我哋35+係個理念係一致嘅，大家都係想為香港人爭取最大嘅利益，為香港好嘅，呢個大家係要記住，係啦。咁而頭先第二個問題就係話會唔會驚俾人 DQ？ 我自己係作為一個工程師，係啦，我係一個好奉公守法嘅香港市民，係符合曬基本法所有嘅法例，我亦都係揸住香港特別行政區嘅護照，係冇其他外國護照。咁好似我嘅對手係好似之前嘅選舉話佢係有外國護照嘅，咁呢個反而咧可能要擔心嘅，反而係一啲保皇黨或者係建制派，佢哋會唔會被 DQ 咧？佢哋都應該要擔心。
我就簽咗確認書啦，因為呢個係我同其他佔議政嘅幾個議員啦，同其他民主派嘅候選人都有傾過先決定嘅。咁舊年我區議會選舉我就簽啦，所以我覺得呢個都係一個 consistent 嘅做法。咁至於你話 DQ 唔 DQ， 我諗如果你話即係反對政府嘅人，或者係嚟自民主派嘅人，就要俾人 DQ 咧，即係咁個個都俾人 DQ 啦。即係我都唔需要去諗呢個問題啦。咁如果即係我哋預想到嘅情況，其實就係我哋到底我哋出嚟參選係為咗乜咧？即係我哋簽確認書呢件事，我諗當然我哋同直選嘅人嘅諗法唔同嘅。我哋會比較著重就係喺個界別去競爭，而我哋最終如果有幸去一對一之下贏到，其實嗰個對民主派嚟講都係一個重大突破嚟嘅。特別後呢要再做任何人，即係贏得到都係一個突破嚟嘅。所以我諗最重要嘅係我哋都要同我哋選民去交代啦。我哋自己既然參與得呢個遊戲，我就要喺遊戲嘅框架、遊戲嘅守則之下，盡我哋最大嘅能力去贏出呢個選舉。如果唔係，即係我諗我哋有負市民期望，有負業界朋友期望。喺舊年區議會選舉，我記得咧，個個提名我嘅人，喺個個經過支持我嘅街坊都會同我講：你入咗去先啦，你做咗候選人，投到贏咗先啦，即係佢亦都係咁嘅態度。而我喺業界入邊聽到嘅聲音都係同一個態度。我哋面對嘅當然你話可能政治上，我諗冇乜嘅民主派咧會質疑我唔夠硬正。我諗我嘅往績已經證明咗我喺民主運動入邊係即係個記錄係好硬正嘅。但是功能組別選舉，我想我們需要作出一些策略的調整，這個是一個重要的事。當然你說大家要記住，最後入到立法會你都是要宣誓擁護基本法，如果你擁護、就是、不擁護基本法，你基本上連參選的門檻都不到。所以你說我們這裡在座這麼多位要去參選的，當然擁護基本法了，大佬、就是、這個是我們的答案嚟噶嘛？即係我哋選擇集體制嘅話，
仲有其他媒體有問題？如果冇咧，咁我哋今日個記者會就去到呢一度啦。咁如果個別再想揾候選人咧，就。